What is up, Superhumans? BT here. Recently, I just announced that I would be retiring from my 20-year career as a personal trainer, and I'm gonna be doing YouTube full-time. So I thought it was very fitting, good timing to show you the YouTube studio. We've got the Unbox Therapy wall, the Nerd wall behind me, but today we're gonna be focusing solely on the workstation. This is where I spend most of my day, and so just recently, I totally revamped the whole thing to make it as productive as possible, but still be really inviting and kind of cozy at the same time. All of the products will be listed down below, so let's get into it. Almost perfect. Why focus on the desk setup instead of something else? Well, I thought, honestly, maybe this is probably the most relatable thing to you out of everything that I have in the studio, like a key light or a camera. It might not be, but especially if you work from home and you're trying to figure out how to make that space work for you, how to make it the most productive space you can possibly have, well, that's why we're going with this. Now, behind this desk, which you can't see, there actually used to be a tiny desk, one that was only about this big, actually less than this, it was about this big, that was actually connected to the wall. I thought a folding desk made a lot of sense because this, as big as this room is, there's not a ton of room to film width-wise. And if I was gonna be doing lots of stuff up against the Unbox Therapy wall, I needed to pull that table as far away from that wall as I could. So I had a desk that folded down into the wall. Now, something else that was here that you can't see was actually this super long shelf. So there was a shelf that went right underneath the pegboard that was only about this wide, which didn't make much sense. But I had a 27-inch iMac. But the iMac rested on that shelf. So I'd be sitting here, but my monitor was like way up here, which wasn't a very comfortable experience at all. And so I'll get into reasons why I ditched that. But when I ditched that, it meant that I kind of had to recreate this entire space. But what I'm left with is something that I love so much more. The thing that really cinched the move for me, going from that old setup to the one that I have currently, is actually this. This tiny little cube is an incredible, amazing camera. It is the Red Komodo. I am always striving to bring a level of production to this channel that not a lot of people can match. I want it to look and feel much more cinematic than other channels. The files that came out of this camera are so beautiful and so amazing, but it would just, the iMac really struggled with them. One stream, so just like one layer of 6K footage, I'd put it on the timeline, it would take forever to import. The moment I tried to tweak color or drop a LUT on it, it just got that beach ball spinning. I managed that from October until about 2 weeks ago, 3 weeks ago, I wanna say. And then for the first time since 2010, I bought a laptop and I bought the brand new M1 Max MacBook Pro. The moment I got the MacBook Pro, I grabbed some Red footage, put it on there, and it went in instantly, and I could instantly like stream through it. I started tweaking the color, it didn't do anything, and I was like, whoa, okay, this is gonna be awesome because I can just edit so much more smoothly, so the experience is going to be so much more enjoyable. I got all the way up to 10 streams of raw footage. It was a little choppy, but it would still play. I could still scrub through it. Absolutely mind-blowing. The old way of doing things on my iMac was I would shoot A-roll, and I would give it an entire day. So even though it would only take me an hour to shoot A-roll, that's like the talking head stuff that I'm doing right now, it would take the rest of the day to import, render, and edit through all of that. And then B-roll would take another day, and then I would have another day to kind of finalize. So every 3 days I could have a video up. Now, because of what this computer can do, I don't need any of that. If I am properly set up and I just have the motivation, I can get an entire video done in a day. One of the best things about this new MacBook Pro is that Apple did something really rare and they kind of like walked back on some of their design decisions and they brought ports back. It's got full-size HDMI, 3 Thunderbolt 4 ports, headphone jack, and an SD card slot, which is amazing. However, even with all of those ports, the amount of dongles and things I need, because I'm using so many different types of media, meant I needed to kind of change things up. I needed something more. This is the CalDigit TS4. And I bought it because it kind of makes a now more permanent solution for all of the different types of media and my port needs. It's got 18 different ports. It has a much faster SD card reader than the MacBook Pro and mini SD reader. Both of them are UHS 2. It's got 2 USB-C ports at the front that are 10 gigs a second, but it also has 3 Thunderbolt 4 ports in the back. That's what I have these connected to. And these are my card readers for CFast and CF Express. And they're just Velcroed onto the TS4 itself. Up front, we've got a USB-A and 4 more USB-As in the back. So when I need to take all of the completed YouTube videos and put them on a hard drive for backup, easily pluggable. Plus it has Ethernet in the back. The MacBook Pro doesn't have Ethernet and I have 2 gig Google Fiber. So I can take full advantage of it using the TS4, but I can't if I'm just rocking the regular MacBook Pro. I would have to buy like another dongle. So to have everything kind of integrated into this is amazing. Now what's cool about this is it has its own power supply. So that's just plugged in to the MacBook Pro. It keeps it charged. And because of the MacBook Pro's battery technology, the battery can last an incredibly long time, even though it's just kind of sipping on power. Then that is plugged in to the new monitor. But I decided to go with this. This is an LG 34-inch ultrawide. And after having an ultrawide, I will never go back. What it does for me as an editor and a creator using Final Cut Pro, like that timeline is just so much better. Like having that extra real estate is absolutely awesome. And one of my favorite things about this is actually the monitor mount I bought. It came with a monitor that actually raised and lowered and you could tilt it, but its bottom footprint was so big that it just wasn't gonna work. So I got this monitor mount from Amazon Basics, and you'd think Amazon Basics, but it actually works really well. And it allows me to do some like pretty incredible like adjusting of this monitor to kind of like whatever I need. If I need it to go lower, it'll even do like portrait mode, which is kind of gnarly. But yeah, now that I've gone like widescreen, I don't think I will ever go back. The MacBook Pro does have incredibly impressive speakers, but if I'm sitting here editing, all of the sound I'm hearing while editing is just coming off from this channel over here. It makes sound design, is what we call it, very difficult. I grabbed this pair off of Amazon. It was like a 4.9 out of 5 stars, and they're also Bluetooth. They sound awesome, and for the price, the quality is outstanding, and being able to connect to them wirelessly via Bluetooth, like the connection process was so simple. They're just great. I really, really like having these while I edit. I've also got a pair of headphones over here that I use by the brand Heyday, little Bluetooth speaker. So in the morning, if it's super early and I'm trying to edit and I don't wanna, you know, make a lot of noise, I'll use these. This is my first foray into mechanical keyboards. This is the Keychron K4, I think it is. I've never had a mechanical keyboard. And I gotta say, as a person who's extremely sensitive to touch, like tactile sensation for me is, man, almost everything. And the clicky, responsive, haptic feedback I get from using a mechanical keyboard is so much more enjoyable than a normal keyboard, like the keyboard that came with my iMac, the ultra thin Magic Keyboard or whatever. It's got crazy RGB backlighting that I almost never use. I've got a wrist rest also by Keychron, also in a wood finish that doesn't match my table and it drives me nuts. But I love this thing. And it took me a little bit to get used to like typing on a mechanical keyboard, but now that I have, I feel like I can type so much faster. I don't know if that's a thing or if placebo effect, if I'm just an idiot, but anyway, if you're a mechanical keyboard person, let me know your experience. For the mouse, I ditched the Magic Mouse from Apple and I went with this. This is the Logitech MX Master 3. It's just so much more ergonomical than a Magic Mouse. Plus, it's covered in buttons that you can map depending on the app you're using. So like when it comes to Final Cut Pro, I've got my side wheel, my scroll wheel, like this will scroll across the timeline. But I've mapped these buttons for like delete and undo, and it's made me so much more efficient because I don't have to take my hand off the mouse to use the keyboard. And that might seem small, but it actually makes a really big difference when it comes to like saving time. This is the 2018 12.9 inch iPad Pro. This thing's a beast, even though it's 4 years old. Like when I got this, I was editing entire videos solely on my iPad. I didn't even use a computer. So it's that powerful, but I use this thing every single day for like thumbnail creation, like when I have to do a thumbnail, or if I'm making graphics for a video using apps like Procreate and Mojo, it just saves me so much time. All of this is kind of resting on this felt pad. I just bought it from Amazon. It's got like rubber grips underneath, but it does a couple things. One, it limits the tappy noise, right? So it's much quieter. So it eliminates that tappy noise from just being on hardwood. It makes it so my mouse can run very smoothly. It cleans up very easily. I've spilt drinks on it a whole bunch and it just soaks. You can soak it right up very quickly so it stays clean. But then it also offers kind of a nice, pleasing contrast to the wood grain, which I really, really like. Now here's a hack for you guys that I just picked up that I really love. One hack is Velcro zip ties. This is like a life hack. These things are ingenious. But here's the other life hack is I literally just stick this to that felt pad and peel it off and it can just like chill here on the desk and it doesn't get in the way. And so it makes using these like zip ties like super easy. This desk is pretty awesome. I really wanted a sit-stand desk, and this one wasn't the cheapest, but it certainly wasn't the most expensive. It's by a brand called Vivo. It's 60 inches, maybe 63 by 30 inches deep. So I've got plenty of space. I've got lots of space. It feels very roomy, but it's in this kind of like weird espresso color. I was hoping it would more closely match my other wood grain stuff. That's just unnerving, but it is a really good desk. It's a sit stand desk, like I said, and what I love about it is it's very easy to control, right? Raising it, lowering it. You can hear it. It's not like the loudest or it's not the quietest desk in the world, but it works really well. I haven't had any issues with it. It's got memory banks, so I can put in like three different heights if I needed. If somebody else worked here, that would kind of make sense. But since nobody else does, and it's just me, getting to the stand feature is really great. And then I've also got enough room now that I can just slide my chair underneath. And everything is just kind of out of the way. It's got a really clean look. It's not the most intense cable management ever, but since nothing's on the floor and I'm not tripping over stuff, that's all I care about. There's obviously a lot more that goes into the studio. There's so much more gear and everything, cameras, lighting, sliders, all sorts of equipment that goes into making these videos. If you're more interested in seeing a follow-up to this, me covering like all this stuff in the studio, let me know if you have any interest in that. Hit that like button. That's definitely going to tell me, but it's also going to let the YouTube algorithm, which is an absolute dirty mistress, maybe it'll push that video up so that it can be seen more easily by other people just like you. And to keep up to date on all of the latest videos and information I am pumping out, make sure that you hit that subscribe button and the little bell next to it. It's free. That's nice. Plus, it also makes you eligible to win some of the kick-ass giveaways that we do on this channel. Thanks again for watching. Thanks for taking this very mini tour of my desk with me. I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.